And then the White House not acknowledging the false claim, but basically pretending it just never happened. Actually, there are two claims the president recently made, two phone calls that the president said he took from people who wanted to praise him, phone calls it turns out that never actually happened. Let's start with a phone call the president talked about Monday.
Even the president of Mexico called me. They said their southern border, very few people are coming because they know they're not going to get through our border, which is the ultimate compliment.
That same day, the office of the president of Mexico issued this statement saying, quote, President Enrique Peña Nieto has not been in recent communication via telephone with President Donald Trump. Today, Sarah Huckabee Sanders was asked about this discrepancy at the White House, why the president said the Mexican president called him when he didn't.
On Mexico, he was referencing the conversation that they had had at the G20 summit where they specifically talked about the issues that he referenced.
The other fake phone call was made, according to the president, by the head of the Boy Scouts. You'll remember the president spoke at the Boy Scout Jamboree, where he gave a speech the Boy Scouts later apologized for, in case anyone was offended by how political and partisan the speech got. Last week, the president gave an interview to the Wall Street Journal. Politico published the full transcript, and in it, the Wall Street Journal mentions that reaction to the speech from former scouts seemed mixed, at which point the president said there was a standing ovation from the time he walked out until 5 minutes after he'd already gone, that he would be the first to admit mixed, and there was no mix. Also, he said, and I quote, I got a call from the head of the Boy Scouts saying it was the greatest speech that was ever made to them, and they were very thankful. Today, an official with the Boy Scouts said they were not aware of any phone calls between the group's leadership and the president, and their apology from last week stands. The White House press secretary was asked about that as well today and admitted that the Boy Scout call, that didn't happen either.
Multiple members of the Boy Scout leadership following his speech there that day congratulated him, praised him, and offered quite powerful compliments following his speech, and those were what those references were about.
Well, when she was pressed on this, Sarah Huckabee Sanders insisted it was just a matter of semantics.
They were actually direct. They were direct conversations, not actual phone calls.
So he lied. He didn't receive.
I wouldn't say it was a lie. That's pretty bold accusation. The conversations took place. They just simply didn't take place over a phone call that he had them in person.
Well, whether it was a lie, an embellishment, a simple mistake, wouldn't it be refreshing if the White House actually just acknowledged that the president was wrong, just saying, yeah, the president was mistaken. He's human. We all make mistakes. But everyone who works for this president knows never, ever admit the boss was wrong. Now, you might say these are minor things, two non-existent phone calls in which adoring people heap praise on the president. And you would be right. These are minor things. But that's sort of the point. If the president so casually says things that aren't true about minor phone calls, if he makes up stuff so easily, especially stuff involving the president of another country, why should anyone believe him on the big stuff, the things that really do matter? And these calls are just the latest example. I mean, remember those extremely credible sources who told him President Obama wasn't born in the United States. Remember the investigators he supposedly sent to Hawaii who, quote, couldn't believe what they were finding. Remember the bragging about the size of his inaugural crowd. Remember the millions of people who supposedly voted illegally. Remember his friend Jim who won't go to Paris because it isn't Paris anymore. There's simply no evidence that any of that is actually real. None. There is evidence that Donald Trump likes to make things up. He has in the past admitted to using a pseudonym to pose as his own publicist. A little over a year ago, the Washington Post reported that Trump routinely called reporters in the 1970s, 1980s, and into the 1990s under the name John Miller or John Barron. This is some of the audio that surfaced of so-called John Miller talking to a People magazine reporter about Trump in the early 90s, around the time he was getting his first divorce.
He's coming out of a marriage and he's starting to do tremendously well financially. There's a real estate depression in the United States, and he's probably doing as well as anybody there is. But he treated his wife well, and he will treat Mama well. And, you know, he's somebody that has a lot of options. And frankly, he gets called by everybody. He gets called by everybody in the book in terms of women.
He goes on to brag about Madonna wanted to go out with him. Wanted to go out with Donald Trump. Last May, when confronted with the recordings, Mr. Trump told the Today Show he didn't think it sounded like that was him. It sounded like that was him. Maybe his base doesn't believe he makes up things all the time. Maybe they do and they just don't care. But at some point, there's going to be a real crisis involving this country, as a lot of people pointed out. And the president will have to look into the camera and speak to all Americans. Let's hope in that moment he chooses his words carefully so that all of us can, in that moment at least, believe what's coming out of his mouth.